Now is the time to sell everything because we have the first indications that a widespread economic crash is about to hit the US and worldwide economy. The reason that we know this is because of the earnings reports that were just released by Walmart and Target. These earnings reports were stunningly bad and have led to massive drops in the stock prices of both of these companies, who combined account for nearly $700 billion of sales. And so when Target and Walmart start to struggle, that is a sign that a recession is coming. Take a look at this, folks. This is an article from CNN Business Today. Target posts a stunning drop in profit, stock plunges. Retail giant reported a 52% drop in profit for the first quarter. Why did they report this drop in profit? Well, let's ask Target CEO. He says, Target shoppers are concerned about the high and persistent inflation they've been experiencing, particularly in food and energy. This is resulting in consumers spending less on bigger ticket items such as televisions and exercise equipment. And that, get this, folks, Target was forced to write down the value of excess inventory that's stuck in their warehouses. And so what Target's performance is really saying is that the American consumer is on strike. They are tapping out. They do not want to pay these higher prices due to inflation, because for over a year now, the growth in inflation has outstripped the growth in wages. This means that the American consumer has been getting poorer over the last year. And now that stimulus checks have run out and a year of inflation has taken place, the American consumer is naturally cutting back. This is something I've talked a lot about on this channel over the last couple months. But folks, the situation was even worse than I expected, because I decided to dig in a little further and I actually looked back at over 20 years of SEC filings by Target to see just how bad their current earnings report is, and by extension, how much trouble the US economy and the stock market is right now, and the results shocked me. So the first thing we're looking at on this graph is the blue line, the annual growth in sales that Target had at its stores. And you can see that we had a big burst in sales growth through the first quarter of 2021, year over year. Kind of in the middle of the pandemic, right after the stimulus checks were released, Target grew sales by 23%. However, in the last year, they've only grown sales by 4%, part of the disappointing earnings report. But really where this gets scary for Target and the US economy is when we layer on the yellow line, the growth in inventory, the amount of goods and items that are on retail shelves in Target, as well as in their warehouses. We can see inventory is up 43% year over year for Target. And what this essentially means is that Target ordered too many goods in 2020 and 2021 during the pandemic, because they thought that the demand for those goods was going to continue into the future and they were going to keep achieving those high sales growth figures. But now that the sales growth is back down to normal levels, all of a sudden we have clothes and exercise equipment and electronics and lawn chairs and landscaping equipment just stocking up on the store shelves at Target. And worse yet, if we look at data from Walmart, we see the exact same thing. And astonishing 34% growth in inventory compared to only a 3% growth in sales. So we've had this crazy shift from 2020 and 2021 during the initial stages of the pandemic, when store shelves were empty, there were shortages everywhere, to today in 2022, where store shelves are largely full. And in fact, these corporations now have too many goods on hand and they're gonna need to start cutting the prices on those goods in order to sell them. This price cutting is gonna lead to deflationary pressures across the US economy, which I know is hard to fathom right now, that we could be seeing deflationary pressures, but specifically in the physical goods economy, you know, those things I talked about, like toys and electronics and merchandise and clothes and lawn chairs, the physical goods economy, we're gonna see lower prices going forward, which is actually gonna be good for you as a consumer. However, it's likely gonna trigger a recession, because now that Target and Walmart have so much inventory on hand, they're not gonna need to order as many goods from their suppliers over the next 1 to 2 years, which is gonna trigger an economic downturn. There's gonna be layoffs, there's gonna be job losses all across the US economy, and we're gonna continue to see asset prices collapse, not only in the stock market and the crypto market, but also in the housing market. Because homes are another physical good that there was a big surge in demand for during the pandemic, especially combined with the low interest rate environment that the Federal Reserve created during the pandemic. So a lot of people wanted to buy homes. And in response, home builders ramped up production. They ramped up the inventory production of these homes to the point that we now have over 1.6 million housing units actively under construction, according to data from the U.S. Census Bureau that was just released today. That's the highest level that we've seen in over 40 years. And so we have home builders working feverishly to build homes to meet the demand that they experienced over the last 2 years. However, demand currently is plummeting. The National Association of Homebuilders just released a report yesterday that said that home buyer traffic for newly constructed homes is down an astronomical 29% year over year through May. And why are there nearly 30% fewer home buyers looking for a new home right now in May of 2022? Well, let's ask the National Association of Home Builders. In a sign that the housing market is now slowing, home builder confidence took a steep drop in May as growing affordability challenges in the form of rapidly rising interest rates, double-digit price increases for material costs, and ongoing home price appreciation are taking a toll on home buyer demand. The chairman of the NAHB said that housing leads the business cycle and now housing is slowing. And so folks, are you seeing the connection here between home builders and Walmart and Target? Pretty much over the entire US economy over the last 2 years, we ordered too much and we built too much. How did this overproduction happen? Well, during the initial stages of the pandemic, there was a legitimate surge in consumer demand, namely from stimulus checks and artificially low interest rates. As a result, retailers like Walmart and Target ordered way too many goods in anticipation of future demand that never came to pass, and now their inventory is spiking. Meanwhile, home builders basically said, hey, look at all the demand for housing in 2020 and 2021. Let's now build a record amount of new homes, a record amount of new homes under construction. Well, they're doing that just as home buyer traffic is down by 30%. And what this speaks to is that we're already in a recession right now in the physical goods economy in America. Expect over the next 1 to 2 years that the prices of physical goods are going to drop by a lot. This would include electronics, furniture, houses, cars. My advice to all of you out there is that if you're thinking of making a big ticket purchase right now, especially one that would be financed with debt, hold off, because now is the exact wrong time to do it as the inventory is building up and we're heading towards a recession. Expect the prices of these things to come down. And this could be a good thing for consumers, right? We've been waiting for some relief, especially on physical goods, for the prices of these things to go down. However, there is a negative to all of this, and that's that declining prices of physical goods are likely going to lead to a recession. We're already starting to see layoffs occur in certain industries like tech. I believe we're going to continue to see those layoffs occur and spread to other parts of the economy like retail and manufacturing. This recession and these job losses will result in consumer demand going down even further and inventory spiking even higher, which is going to cause further price drops. And as this is all occurring, we're going to see asset prices collapse. We're already seeing the stock market down by 20 to 30%. We're already seeing the crypto market down by 30%. We're going to see the housing market go as the next domino. And these asset values going down is going to create another headwind for consumer spending because the wealth effect that Americans have experienced over the last 2 years is going to go away. You know, when the value of someone's home went up by 40%, 50%, they said, I can spend more money today because my net worth is higher. Well, that's going to go into reverse. And so in addition to advising you guys to hold off on purchases of big ticket items, big physical goods, I'm tripling down on my suggestion of stockpiling cash. I think that is so important right now to save as much money as you can. If you are able to save more money, do it. If you can find room in your budget to cut discretionary spending a bit so you can put more money in your bank account, do it. I did a video on this last week. I'm tripling down on that recommendation in light of these new developments with Walmart and Target. You're gonna be happy you have the extra cash buffer in a year when the prices of goods go down and when a lot of people start losing their job. To be clear, I am not a registered financial advisor, and if you're considering making big changes in your investments or your spending, it would likely be wise to consult a financial advisor before doing that. Now, a question I think is building on a lot of your minds as I'm going through this video is the government going to do something to stop this all from happening? We, of course, saw the government go to crazy extremes during the pandemic to support the economy. Are we going to see the government go back to sending stimulus checks out? Are we going to see the Federal Reserve reverse course and start cutting interest rates instead of increasing interest rates? And of course, you know, this is a tough question to answer. No one can truly predict what the government's going to do in the future. However, I think it's going to be very difficult for either the Fed or the US government to come to the rescue right now. That's because the US economy is in a very unique position right now, one that it hasn't been in for nearly 50 years, where the rate of inflation, the red line, is actually well above the unemployment rate, the blue line. You can see that here on this graph. And so long as the inflation rate stays above the unemployment rate, the Federal Reserve really needs to keep increasing interest rates because they have a dual mandate, a dual charter by Congress to pursue maximum employment and maintain stable prices. With the unemployment rate at a record low, 3.6%, maximum employment is more than achieved. However, with inflation at over 8%, price stability certainly is not. So these are the two metrics the Fed is going to be using to decide how long they should continue to increase rates, and then finally when they should cut rates. And just to give you all some perspective, the situation was completely different 2 years ago when the Fed cut rates, printed money, and then the government did stimulus checks. The unemployment rate was close to double digits, north of 10%, while the rate of inflation was close to zero when all of the crazy government assistance started. And so it was this situation where the blue line unemployment rate was way above the red line that allowed all the people in the government to justify crazy intervention into the economy. And my personal prediction is that we're going to need to see the inflation rate go below 5% and the unemployment rate go above 5% before we're going to see any meaningful action taken by the Federal Reserve to go back to accommodative monetary policy and cutting rates and printing money. And that shift is not likely to occur overnight because it's not as if millions of people are suddenly going to get laid off in a matter of months. It's going to take time for the unemployment rate to tick up, and it's going to take time for the inflation rate to tick down, because even as we're going to see reduced goods prices, which is going to bring inflation down, we are likely to continue to see higher energy and gas costs, which are going to push inflation up. And so this is really a nasty situation that the economy is facing right now, where a recession seems inevitable just at the same time that the Fed is tightening monetary policy and that their hands are tied as far as that goes, at least for probably 6 to 12 months. That says to me that in addition to avoiding large purchases and saving money, I'm going to be selling most of the assets that I have in terms of the stock market, in terms of crypto, in terms of real estate. If you guys were deciding whether you should pull the trigger on selling real estate, now would probably be a good time to do it because asset values are going to collapse all around us. Now, with that said, I think there are certain investments that still could weather the storm pretty well. I've had my eye on certain stocks in certain specific cities and housing markets that I think are going to be recession-proof. I'm going to talk more about those in a video next week. So if you want to see my recommendations for some recession-proof investments, make sure you're subscribed or smash that subscribe button and turn on those subscribe notifications. Additionally, make sure to smash that like button. Hitting the like button is the best way you can support me in this channel and get me to produce more of this content into the future.